Alright YouTube, in this video I'm going to show you how to create a Laravel mini project. So what do I mean by that? The topic for this video is maintenance payment history. So consider you are in an apartment and the apartment has a floor. So let's say we have first floor, we are in first floor. So those first floor member are paying the maintenance to you and you want to save the date and to whom the maintenance is paid. So this is the project that displays the details. So consider in our apartment there is first floor, and in the first floor there are 6 rooms, and in 6 rooms they are going to pay maintenance to you. Like say if 103 is going to pay maintenance, so I am receiving the maintenance. So what I'll do is I'll just click on check and it will say room number 103 is paying the maintenance today to Vishal. So Vishal is me and I'm clicking on save. Once I click on save, what should happen is the data is saved and it's ready to display. So in this case what you can do is you can print the screen and share it to the relevant WhatsApp group in the member where your apartment members are. So actually now this is clear, this is the introduction, and you can see the data is edited. What if you want to modify the date or you want to delete it? To delete the date, what you can do is you can just uncheck it and it says erase. Just click on erase and you can see the data is erased. The same way, if some other guy pays the maintenance, you can just add the name of the other guy who accepts the payment. Like my neighbor also accepts the payment of maintenance, you can add his name over here and click on save, and you can see 106, room number 106 has paid the maintenance on 30th Jan to John. The same way you can add maintenance details about anyone, and this is the simple CRUD. So in this case, in this CRUD operation, we will just focus on update and read. Fine, let's start. If you erase, the data will be erased. Fine. Now what we are going to do is the very first thing what I'm going to do is to follow along, I'll leave a source code in the description so that you can join me. So this is the Laravel version 6, and if you notice the version 6 documentation is also open on the sidebar. Make sure it's on the 6. So these are the steps which we are going to follow in this particular tutorial. The first one is we are going to install Laravel project. To install Laravel project, we need to get the code, CMD code. So for that, you just have to type install. And I would recommend to read all this, but I'm going to skip it. So this is a code that we can create the Laravel project. At present, I'm not going to open this project anymore. If you want to revisit again, just the first 3 minutes is of this explanation of this video. Fine, now I'm going to close this project, Control C, and I'm going to add the code. So our current project name is going to be we'll call something as flat details. Just get out from the htdocs, and inside the htdocs we have a folder called Laravel, cd Laravel, and inside the Laravel install the project. So if you notice, in the C drive we have a XAMPP, inside the XAMPP we have htdocs, inside the htdocs we have Laravel folder, inside the Laravel folder we have our flat details project. So this is the flat details project which is getting created right now in front of you. You see, it is installing all these stuffs. By the time it's installed, we'll create a database. Make sure your XAMPP is open. This is a live server along with the phpMyAdmin. So click on new. We are going to create a database, and the database name is going to be maintenance details. So let me save the maintenance details. So I'm just, for this particular tutorial, I'm just mentioning the first floor itself. You can add you can add the whole details, like if your apartment has 6 floors and each floor has 6 rooms, you can add those 6 floors and 6 rooms just below here. So this is just an explanation of first floor, and that is also clear. Now we have added the created the database, and let's see whether our installation is completed or not. So far it's not completed. So installing Laravel project is done, create database is done. Now we have to create the controller. To create the controller, first the projects is done. Now let's create a controller on the documentation. Click on controller. So this is a code for creating controller. The controller name is going to be details, DALS, details controller. Just type it, make sure you are inside the current project. What we have named it as flat details, and type the controller code, and the controller is saved successfully. Now let's open this in our texture HTML editor, which is Visual Studio Code. Let's select the folder, and it will take some time. Now what we need to do is we are going to add this resource into our web.php page. So this is the URL. We want the URL to be named as details, and the controller that is going to handle is details, which we have just now created. Just add this code in the web.php, and now you can check php artisan route list. We can check the URL, available URL. We can use these URLs. So these are the URLs. We will just use the two URL. The first one is for showing, which is details, and the second is for updating, which is details slash the relevant ID. Now it is clear. Now we have created a route list. We have to create a model now. Let's create a model. PHP artisan make model. The model name is going to be details model, and we need to add the migration file. So that's why I'm adding dash m. Click on save. Now the migration file is created. Sorry, get into the database. Inside the database we have migration. So this is a table, this is a file where we need to add some columns. The first column, we need to add 3 columns. So the columns are going to be string. The first one is room number, the second one is paid 2 is going to be the number name. So paid at is going to be the date. So I'm keeping it as string format, no issues. Now what we need to do is without touching the PHP myadmin, I want to populate the tables. So for that you have to just write the code PHP artisan migrate. Click on enter, and what it says, unknown. Okay, we have not modified the env file. So let's get into the env file. So here we need to give the database name, which we have created now. This, so now we have to type php artisan migrate. Now migration is successful. Now if you get into the database, these table are populated, and this is the table which we have particularly named the columns. Now the column name is also available. Let's store this into our notepad. Fine. Now migration file is also now done. Now we need to manually create some columns. So as we know, we have some list of, let's take the screenshot, anyway it will not work. If I refresh, it will go away because currently the server is blocked. Now if you see, what these are the details which we need to add manually. So if you see, insert 101 102, click on go and insert again 103 104, click on go and insert again 105 106, click on go, and now click on browse. If you see, those six columns are available. Paid to and paid out is blank. Fine, we'll leave it as it is. So we'll just use only paid to Vishal, and paid out is going to be some date. Fine, now I have manually inserted so that we can check the checkbox. So now the next step, migration is done, inserted required column is also done, show all values from table. So we want to show all the values from the table and display into a file. So what is really going to happen is PHP artisan, we have to check the migration, we have to check the route list. So we want to show the details. To show the details, what is going to happen is the Laravel will check on the index file. So let's get into the controller, app controller, HTTP controller, and on the index file I want to return a view, and that view is going to be show all details. So let's save this view on the resources views here. On the resources folder we have views folder. Inside the views folder I'm going to save the HTML. Control N, save the name of the file .blade.php. Click on save. The data is saved. Now we have to use the bootstrap. Bootstrap for CDNs. So I'm getting into the W3 school. Just paste this entire blank HTML. Now if you click, if you get into the, we have to run the project PHP artisan serve. Localhost port 8000, actually it's colon. And we know we have to get into details because we have used the route details. Missing semicolon on the controller. Fine, now we can edit this. Maintenance details. Now we can create the table with class table, and inside table we can use table head, and inside table head we can use table row. Inside table row we need to use table data. Inside table data there are row number, paid, which is checkbox, paid to, which is going to be name, paid at, which is going to be the date. Fine, now we have to get all the details from the database and display it over here. To get the details, to get the data from the database, you have to use model, use app. Inside the app we have a model. The name of the model is details model. Details model. And now use the model, use the facade, or you can say eloquent, all, get all the store all the values into the variable called all details, and send the variable which contains all the details to the view with the function with Now we can access this value over here. So for each as, so let's give a variable called $x and end the for each at the rate end for each. Just copy the same thing. Now we just have to make sure all the column names are right. Here the column name is going to be room number. The second column is for checkbox. We'll move it in a minute. Paid to, paid at. Now if you notice, all the values are available. So let's fill one more value. Let's call this John, and John has entered some date. Now we have to add the checkbox here. Input type checkbox. Can see checkbox is available. I want the checkbox to be checked only if there is paid to is inserted. So for that we are going to use the ternary operator. If we have paid to variable set, then I want to add checked, or else it should be blank. Now if you notice, these two values are checked because the value is inserted. So let's try to add one more value and check. Vishal and some date, the payment received date. So if you refresh, this has populated dynamically with checked. Fine, that is working. Now what I need to do is, once I click on the checkbox, I want a model to open. So for that, what we can do is get the model code. This is the model code. Just paste it just above the body, closing of body. And now we have to write the script tag. Script for if check box is checked, open model. So on the Stack Overflow we can easily get the code. So this is not a jQuery code, I'm just copy pasting it. I'll explain it. So if in this particular document, get all the checkboxes, and if there's a change on the checkbox, what you have to do is, we are changing the checkbox. There can be two state, either checked or unchecked. If the status is checked, then open the model. So we are passing the E. With the E we can get the current element. Now if you see, if I click on this particular checkbox, the E is going to be this particular element. Let me inspect it. console.log e dot parallel. Now let me refresh it. So if I change the state of this one, and now on the console, on the message, you can see this checkbox. Now if I hover it, you see it is highlighting. So if I check this checkbox, and if I hover this one, now if you see, out of all the checkbox which I have currently clicked is getting highlighted. So that is the main thing here which we are going to apply logic on. So if this is checked, what I need to do is, I want to get this value. So before getting this value, I want to create a form on the model. So let's create a form. Let's keep the method as post. And the action is blank. Now we need a class called form group. and inside form group I want a label, and the label is going to be room number, and I want an input field with input type text, and the name is going to be room number, and it is going to be disabled. Let's give the ID as well the same. Why I'm giving it disabled, I'll let you know in a minute. So the second one is going to be date, accepted date, input type date. So here we'll use the same thing, paid at as the name and as the ID. We don't want this to be disabled, we want it to be editable. And finally, accepted by, it is going to be the text. Paid to, and finally the submit button. Form group text center, input type submit. We don't want the name, we want the ID to be submit. And now accepting payment as the heading of the model. So if I click on the, what do you call, if I click on the checkbox, you can see the model is available. Now just need to add the class called form control. This is a bootstrap class which will add some padding to make our form controls, or you can say form, a bit easy to look. Fine. Now we have room number, we have date, and we have accepted by. Let's add the class to this also. Class btn success. Wait, I'm refreshing it. Now if I click on this paid button, I want the data room number to be 101. So why 101? Because I have clicked on the radio button which is adjacent to 101. The same way, if I click on 105, I want the adjacent data 105 to be available on room number. So you have to get into the JavaScript. If it is checked, I want to call the checkbox. So checkbox has a parent. So the parent is TD. So from the TD, I want the adjacent TD. So previous element sibling. So from the previous element TD, I want the inner text. And let me name it as what? The room number. Just console. Sorry for the spelling. console.log, save the variable, and let's see, inspect it, console. If we click on paid, you can see 103 is available, 101 is available. If I click on 103, 103 is available. So I'm getting the 103 and I'm calling the form which is inside the model, inside the model dot find the tag called form, and inside the form I want to find get this ID dot find. Then let's add attribute value, and the value is going to be room number. Now let's see. Fine, 101 is available on the input field. And now if I click on 105, 105 is also available, but it is editable. I don't want this to be editable. I want it to be disabled. The spelling is wrong. This a build. refreshing it. Now you can see 105 is not, now it is not editable. So along with that, what I need is, so far we are going good. Now what we need is, we want to use the update operation. So to use the update operation, the very first thing is we need to use a form. So whenever we are using Laravel, the form should have CSR cost site request forgery. And then let's check the route list. Control C, PHP, artisan, route list. Now we need to use the update method. So to use the update method, the only way to use is the URL details. So there is a condition, we have to use the ID also. So if you see 101 as an ID called 1, so this ID we need to pass it on the form action. So why form action? Because the URL related to update is, update has the ID. So again we are going to use the JavaScript. So there is a trick, we need to pass the ID to the action. So to pass the ID on the action, first we need ID. So where can we get the ID? So let's add an input field hidden. Let's add the value, and this value will hold the ID. Now if you refresh and check on the inspect, the room number will have an input field hidden. Let's open the artisan PHP artisan serve. Along with room number, we will have hidden, and the ID is also available here. Now with the help of traversing, which we just did, we need to get the ID. So to get the ID, instead of inner text, you have to use what we can use, query selector. And inside the query selector, we need to add input type equal to, we need to add double quotes, hidden, and we need to get the value, and the ID is available. Let's check console.log, refresh it, click on console. If I click on 101, the ID should be 1. Yes, 1 is available. If I click on 103, ID should be 3. 3 is also available. Now we have to pass this ID to the form attribute. Get the form and set the attribute. The attribute is going to be action, and the value is going to be details slash then the ID plus ID. So let's check, click on 101. Now get the form and the form action. Let's see where is the form action. Inside the car model body we have form action details slash 1. So let's choose some 105 and let's again check the form action, and it's details slash 5. So it is working. Now once I click on submit, the data will be accepted by the update function on the controller. So this is the controller. So now we just have to update. To update, we have to use a model, and we have a function called find, and the find will accept the ID which we have passed you through the action, and it will give the relevant column. And this relevant column can be now editable. This has a column called page 2 and this has a column called paid at, and we can receive the input field value from this object reference paid to equal to paid at. And now we just have to run this query once only when the received paid to is set. If it is not equal to blank, if it is not equal to blank, then only save this value. To save the value, again we have a function called save, so after saving I want the values to be redirected, return redirect and the URL is details. We'll write it outside of the if else. I'm purposely making it, adding this condition to let you know the upcoming steps. So now there is a mistake, or either it is semicolon or it is comma. Semicolon is missing. So let's add the 101. 101 paid the maintenance today to Vishal. Click on submit. Post method is not updated, so we have to see the relevant method for updation. So if you see, we are using the update and the URL we have used is right, but we have to use the method either put or patch. We'll use the method put. So get into the form, use method put. To use the method put, make sure you have used method post here. That is also important. Method post is also important. Let's edit 105 has paid the maintenance to Vishal. Click on submit. The post method is not supported. Why post method is not supported? If the post method is not supported, I have used the put here. Why it's not accepting it? So we'll add a put. No issues. Refresh it. Paid the maintenance today to Vishal, submit. And now if you see, this is because of the post method, we are not getting it. We have to use post here, or else it is accepting the get method. So you can see the value is available here. Refresh it. Fill the values. Click on submit. And now as we say, it is updated. Fine. Now let's delete the blank values. And let's try to insert the original values. Refresh it. No, this is the code. And now if you see, let's see, 101 has added purchase, 101 has paid the maintenance on 21st to John. Click on submit. And John has accepted the payment on 21st. The details is available. Likewise, you can insert the values. What if on uncheck, I want the value to be erased? So that is the step we are going to work on now. So if it is checked, then this kind of this code will work. So if else, if it is not checked, what we have to do is we have to call these IDs dollar and want to make the value as null. So let's call these values which is actually the column name of table. I have given it to the input field name. And then what I need to do is I just have to copy paste the same thing. So let's open it. On uncheck, you can see the value is blank here and the accepted by is also blank here. And then I want the input field value. So here I have given it ID submit, input type button, input type submit. I have given it with ID. So these are IDs. I want the value to be erase. Refresh it. Click here. Now you can see erase is available. So once, and there is a mistake. Room number. We don't want the room number to be blank. If you uncheck it, you can see other than room number, the accepted and accepted date and accepted name is blank. So then we want to submit the values to the form, and with the same updation. So again it is going to the update function, and in this case it is not blank. If it is blank, sorry, in this case it is blank. If it is blank, then save the values as blank. Let's see. If I uncheck, if you notice, 101 has paid the payment, and in any case, I want the details to be cleared. That means I want the data to be cleared. Uncheck it. Click on erase. And the data is erased. Uncheck it. So this guy has paid the maintenance to me, but I don't want the payment to be shown, payment details to be shown. So for that, I'll just uncheck it, erase, and now that's done. And if you want to add, you can just add it, the date, and paid to Vishal, click on submit. Fine. I have completed the tutorial. Now to get the source code, just get into the description box and start the work. Thank you so much for listening.